Welcome to Grab and Go Info. There are different methods for sentiment analysis. Some examples are lexicon-based methods, building customized models, using cloud services for sentiment predictions, or using pre-trained language models. In this tutorial, we will compare two state-of-the-art deep learning pre-trained models for sentiment analysis, one from Hugging Face and the other from Flair. We will talk about what are the benefits of a pre-trained model for sentiment analysis, how to use Hugging Face zero-shot classification model for sentiment analysis, how to use Flair pre-trained sentiment model for sentiment analysis, which one of the two models has higher accuracy for sentiment prediction. Let's get started. Firstly, let's talk about the benefits of using a pre-trained classification language model. Compared with lexicon-based sentiment analysis such as Vader or TextBlob, the pre-trained zero-shot deep learning language models are usually more accurate. To learn more about the lexicon-based sentiment analysis, please check out my previous tutorial TextBlob versus Vader for sentiment analysis using Python. The link for the tutorial will be put in the video description. Compared with the customized sentiment analysis models, the pre-trained zero-shot deep learning language models usually utilize a much larger training dataset. Large modeling dataset typically produces better model results. One exception is that if the documents for the sentiment analysis are from a highly specialized domain, a customized sentiment model may work better. A customized classification model needs labeled data, while a zero-shot sentiment analysis model does not need the data to be labeled. This saves the cost of labeling, which is usually pretty high for large datasets. Compared with the cloud services for sentiment analysis such as Amazon Comprehend, Azure Cognitive Service for Language, Google Natural Language API, and IBM Watson Natural Language Understanding API, the open-source pre-trained zero-shot models have much lower cost because they are free to use. In step two, let's talk about the algorithms behind the Hugging Face zero-shot sentiment analysis and the Flair Pretrained sentiment model. Hugging Face zero-shot sentiment analysis uses zero-shot learning, which refers to building a model and using it to make predictions on tasks the model was not trained to do. It can be used on any text classification task, including but not limited to sentiment analysis and topic modeling. Zero-shot sentiment analysis from Hugging Face is a use case of the Hugging Face zero-shot text classification model. It is a natural language inference model where two sequences are compared to see if they contradict each other, entail each other, or are neutral. When using the Hugging Face zero-shot sentiment analysis, we will have the text as the premise and the sentiment labels such as positive and negative as hypotheses. If the model predicts that a text document entails positive, then the document is predicted to have a positive sentiment. Otherwise, the document is predicted to have a negative sentiment. The Flair pre-trained sentiment model is a text classification model explicitly built for predicting sentiments. The modeling dataset set is the IMDb, so it may work better for documents that are similar to the IMDb data than the documents that are quite different from IMDb data. In step 3, we will install and import Python libraries. The link for the code is in the video description. Firstly, let's import transformers and Flair. After installing the Python packages, we will import the Python libraries. Pandas is imported for data processing. Hugging Face pipeline is imported from transformers for the zero-shot classification model. The English sentiment model is loaded from the Flair text classifier. Sentence is imported from Flair to process input text. The accuracy score is imported from model performance. The fourth step is to download and read the dataset. The UCI Machine Learning Repository has the review data from three websites, mdb.com, amazon.com, and yelp.com. We will use the review data from amazon.com for this tutorial. Please follow these steps to download the data. 1. Go to the UCI website for the sentiment analysis dataset. 2. Click Data Folder. 3. Download sentiment labeled sentences.zip. 4. Unzip sentiment labeled sentences.zip. 5. Copy the file Amazon cells labeled.txt to your project folder. Those who are using Google Colab for this analysis need to mount Google Drive to read the dataset. You can ignore the code below if you are not using Google Colab. Drive.mount is used to mount to the Google Drive so the Colab notebook can access the data on the Google Drive. os.chdir is used to change the default directory on Google Drive. I set the default directory to the folder where the review dataset is saved. pwd is used to print the current working directory. Please check out Google Colab tutorial for beginners for details about using Google Colab for data science projects. The link for the tutorial will be put in the video description. Now let's read the data into a pandas data frame and see what the dataset looks like. The dataset has two columns. One column contains the reviews and the other column contains the sentiment label for the review. .info helps us to get information about the dataset. From the output, we can see that this dataset has 1,000 records and no missing data. The review column is the object type and the label column is the int64 type. The label value of 0 represents negative reviews and the label value of 1 represents positive reviews. The dataset has 500 positive reviews and 500 negative reviews. It is well balanced, so we can use accuracy as the metric to evaluate the model performance. In step 5, we will use the Hugging Face 0-shot text classification model to predict sentiment for each review. Firstly, the pipeline is defined. Task describes the task for the pipeline. The task name we use is 0-shot classification. Model is the model name for the prediction used in the pipeline. You can find the full list of available models for 0-shot classification on the Hugging Face website. At the time this tutorial was created in January 2023, the BART Large MNLI by Facebook is the model with the highest number of downloads and likes, so we will use it for the pipeline. Device defines the device type. Device equals 0 means that we are using GPU for the pipeline. After defining the pipeline, the data is processed and the sentiments are predicted by the pipeline. Firstly, the reviews are put into a list for the pipeline. Then, the candidate labels are defined. We set 2 candidate labels, positive and negative. After that, the hypothesis template is defined. The default template is used by the Hugging Face pipeline as this example is. We use a hypothesis template that is more specific to the sentiment analysis the sentiment of this review is, and it helps to improve the results. Finally, the text, the candidate labels, and the hypothesis template are passed into the 0-shot classification pipeline called classifier. The output is in a list format and we converted it into a pandas data frame. The sum of positive and negative scores for each review is 1, indicating the relative score of a review belonging to a sentiment. The first label in the labels list is the predicted sentiment for each review, and the first score in the scores list is the corresponding score prediction. For example, the review Great for the Jawbone has the predicted sentiment of positive and the predicted score of 0.99, indicating that positive is a much more likely sentiment than negative. Note that the score values are not the absolute predicted probability of the sentiment, and it represents only the relative probability among the given candidate labels. To make the prediction results easy to read and process, 2 new columns are created, one for the predicted sentiment and the other for the score of the predicted sentiment. We also appended the true sentiment labels for the reviews. The comparison between the actual and predicted sentiment shows an accuracy score of 96.9%, which is very accurate, especially considering that this is a general pretrained 0-shot text classification model not specific for sentiment analysis. In step 6, we will use the Flair Pretrained sentiment model to predict sentiments for the reviews. Let's define a function that takes a review as input and the score and the predicted label as outputs. Firstly, the review text is passed into the sentence function to get tokenized. Then, we use .predict to make sentiment predictions. After the prediction, we can extract score and value from the sentence. Value is the predicted sentiment label, and score is how confident the model is about the prediction. Finally, the function output the score and the value for the input review. After the function is defined, we can apply the function to each review in the dataset and create the predicted sentiments. From the score distribution, we can see that the minimum score is 0.53 and the average score is 0.99, indicating that the model is very confident about the sentiment predictions. Flair by default outputs text negative and positive as labels. Before checking the prediction accuracy, we need to map the negative value to 0 and the positive value to 1 because the Amazon review dataset has true labels of 0 and 1. The comparison between the actual and predicted sentiment shows an accuracy score of 94.8%, which is less accurate than the Hugging Face prediction accuracy of 96.9%, but is still very accurate. If you have made it this far, you probably find the information in this tutorial helpful. Please click the like button and subscribe to the channel to get notified when I publish new videos like this. To learn more about natural language processing, please click the YouTube playlist on the screen now. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video.